Hey, we're back at it again. How you doing, Pat Porter? Yeah, with the infamous Jay Moore. Actually, it is the infamous Jay Moore Show with Pat Porter.
Yes, thank you. Good afternoon, Pat Porter.
How you doing, Jay?
I'm feeling good, man. It's a great day to be in the radio studio and
it is.
Watching all the nice weather that we're not getting outside yet.
Yeah. You got shirts on. I think you forgot, though. You just got those tidy whiteys on you. Forgot to put the shorts
well,
on.
Well, you know, I wore jeans initially this morning, thinking it was going to be a little cooler, and man, it's too hot out there.
You left them in the back of my car, or what?
You know what? You can do that on radio, because no one's really watching, you know? You can do that kind of thing.
I got to sit here and look at you.
Well, hey, what's the matter with that?
I guess that's fine. Yeah.
I've heard stories about studios losing their air conditioning and guys doing the show almost naked before. I've heard that.
Yeah. Who told you that?
Well, should I say it on the air?
I always wore a suit and tie every time
I
did a show.
I heard the story from Tim Dennis. Yes, he told me that happened before.
And knowing Tim Dennis, it probably did.
Yes, yes. Well, he's been in radio a long time. I'm sure he's been in a lot of studios that didn't have air conditioning.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I remember doing that, too, at a radio station that was noted for never having heat or air conditioning.
Yeah.
And you'd have to go in there with a jacket, you know, in the summer, because it was freezing cold, or else it was too hot, and you had to start removing everything, and hopefully nobody came in and
these
said, whoa!
These radio stations never seem to get it right.
Well, right here, right 4680Q, it's perfect in here.
I love it in here.
We can look out on Chrysler Avenue and see all the people walking
and
by.
Great because we're on digital radio. We're protecting our jobs. We're protecting ourselves. How do you feel, Pat Porter? All these radio stations are crumbling all over the province.
Isn't that sad?
Yes.
Yeah, one big company starts with a B.
Yeah.
Everybody knows who that is.
Yes.
Nine stations bit the dust yesterday.
Ooh.
Nine.
Nine.
9 a.m. stations. Yeah, they're all gone. Yeah. Everybody, sorry guys, you're locked out. That's the end of your job.
Yeah.
It's fading fast.
Yes.
But with these podcasts, you can listen to these over and over anytime you want.
Anytime you want. We're married to social media, basically.
Yeah.
You know, I'm going to try to get on an expert next week to talk about radio. What do you think of that?
I think that's a great idea.
An expert in the trade, an expert in the industry. I'm going to hold back right now because I haven't reached out yet.
Okay.
But I'm pretty confident that next week, I'm going to have a segment on this very program regarding terrestrial radio and the new digital platforms and what's going on across everywhere.
Well, one thing I know that I found out, I read all the trade magazines and everything. They're all online now, as a matter of fact, anyway.
Yeah, nobody prints anything anymore.
No. And so apparently podcasts are now twice the volume of people paying attention and listening to than AM radio.
Oh, whoa. I got a very special call on this hotline, Pat Porter. You better not screw this up. Better not screw this up.
All right. Let's just answer the call. Hello there. How are you?
Hey, good. This is John with AEW. How are you?
Good, John. We are on the air, I must say that. But we are awaiting the great RJ City.
Perfect. I have him on, so let me just transfer him over one sec.
Thank you.
All right, here we go. Push the right button.
You did it right, finally, Papa.
I did something right.
RJ, we're on with Jay.
Hello.
RJ City!
I don't do that anymore. It's been years.
I wanted to do it for old times' sake. Is that so wrong?
I know.
Is that so wrong?
It's totally fine.
RJ,
I'll allow it.
I am so happy that you've graced our airwaves, that you are here. I love you. I'm a huge fan, of course. And also, who's a huge fan that told me to say hi to you, Mr. Andrew Dice Clay said he's seen you at the Comedy Store.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
You know, sometimes he rips his jackets because he's gotten larger over the years and he does so many hand movements and I patch up his jacket.
Oh, you do?
That's why he's such a big fan of mine. I'll tell you who said hi to you.
Oh.
I'll return the favor with a hello.
Oh, thank
you. Canada's own Sean Spears.
Oh, Mr. Sean Spears. I was going to end this interview by saying, say hello to Sean Spears and David Arquette. But you know what? You just stole my heat. And it sounded great.
I'm so sorry.
Yes.
What else is new?
Nothing else is new. Dice told me he was a big fan of Hey, EW, and he loved when you used to make coffee in his underwear. And that's all I had to say about that.
Yes, I used to make it in his underwear.
Oh, in
and
his
then
underwear.
He said, I don't think you're fitting these anymore.
No.
Yes, it was a long story.
Yes. He's gotten much too big. Are you helping him in the gym? I mean, he's getting older, but it's Dice. We all love Dice.
We're working on mobility now.
Yes.
Mainly with the cigarette.
Oh, okay. He still has the cigarette going. Okay.
Yes.
Well, it's a great part of his
smoke it. He holds it. you know?
Yes, yes, yes. He still has it. He can't let it go. He doesn't light it, but he still has it there. It's perfect.
No, yeah. These are your questions?
No, RJ City, I am pumped up. I am excited about tonight. You're in Chicago, and this is the debut of Collision, baby. And there's been a buzz in the streets about this. How are you feeling?
And you're very far away from those streets. I'm on the street where the show is, and there is yes. an even bigger buzz. There's a different mood in the air tonight because there are plenty of, I would say, combustible elements that seem to be coming together for this show. I will say I'm thrilled that the official theme song is Saturday Night's All Right for Fighting by Elton John.
No, I was going to mention that. I was going to mention that because I think that you probably had a hand in picking that song.
I wish I did.
Okay.
I suggested One Saturday Morning from the Disney Channel.
Oh,
and
okay.
I think Tony said, maybe not.
No.
And then Elton is a big fan of Miro, and that's yes. how we got him.
Yes, that's perfect.
And,
go ahead, RJ.
I will say, I was going to also say a little thing. I got to look at the brand new set.
Oh, we have a new
Collision set. Yeah, it's a whole new design. It's beautiful. It's in keeping with this sort of futuristic theme they have going on.
Excellent.
And it's a little lost in space. It's a little Jonathan Harris, and it's fine by me.
Excellent. So we're going to get something that looks different from Rampage, looks different from Dynamite. This is a brand new brand. This is Collision, and it's going to be good.
I would hope it would be good. I wouldn't be promoting it if it wasn't
No,
good.
Absolutely. I'm trying to build it up more because you mentioned Miro. He's returning tonight, is he not? Andrade's returning tonight.
Yes.
Yes.
Other people are on the show, like Thunder Rosa and House of Black.
Yes.
And apparently the Acclaimed are appearing tonight.
Also
and then you got a main event like you've never heard. It feels like a random video game simulation, this main event.
Yes.
It's CM Punk and FTR against Bullet Club Gold and Samoa Joe.
Yes, this is perfect.
Is ridiculous.
This is absolutely perfect.
It is perfect.
You're never going to get a match like that anywhere, and you're going to get it tonight on this. This is going to be amazing. That alone is worth everything to me. Also, you forgot to mention TNT Championship on the line tonight. Wardlow, and Luchasaurus.
Yes, and Sky Blue and Willow Nightingale. Sky Blue I talked to last week.
Okay.
My interview with her blew up because she has, she delved into her questionable past. She lit a child on fire. I'm not going to get into it right
my.
Now.
That's fine.
Sky Blue and Willow Nightingale.
Okay.
Against Toni Storm and Ruby Soho.
Okay. Now, this is a perfect way to spend a Saturday night. And also, Chicago, it's kind of the return for CM Punk in his hometown. So that's got to be worth something.
Kind of. He hasn't been around in 9 months. This is the big one. This is the United Center. It's crazy to be backstage and see, you know, the Chicago Bulls stuff. And then you got the Chicago Blackhawks stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're like, oh, yeah, we're going to be a part of this building.
That's
and then
right.
What I do think is even nicer is that, you know, Chicago fans are a little rowdy. But I'll tell you who's even more culturally judgmental is the place we're taking Collision to next week, which, of course, is Toronto.
Yes, and that is going to be a huge deal, especially for me here. I'm going to be at that show because I will never miss Collision in Toronto. Can you give us a little teaser about that?
Well, I don't know anything that's planned.
It's going to be good because you got to follow tonight, and tonight is huge. And so Toronto, we all know that wrestling in Toronto is huge, so there's no way you're going to come in unprepared.
No, and you know that if you do come in unprepared, the Toronto fans will eat you alive.
They will eat you alive.
Which is really the joy of being in Toronto.
Yes, yes.
Which is why you and I don't do anything anymore.
That's right.
But also, on top of that, obviously on the Sunday, we have Forbidden Door in Toronto. So my theory is, and this is just me a spitballing,
okay,
is that tonight and next week for the Collision in Toronto, I think you will see a lot of Forbidden Door developments.
Wow.
Take place. Everybody wants to put their cards on the table before Forbidden Door.
Yes, yes. You are perfect for this job. Like you said, Rota Wrestling, but you are absolutely perfect at promoting this AEW. This is amazing. Toronto's going to be amazing. Chicago's going to be amazing. And let's talk about it. They can get it in Toronto on TSM Plus. Because we've seen
they
you
can
on that.
Get it in Toronto on TSM. Yes. All Collisions will be available on TSM Plus.
Yes.
It is my understanding, and I think Renee and I will be making a more formal announcement soon, on TSN that some of the Canadian shows will be available to air live on one of the TSN channels.
Yes, and I love that. And I love that it's going to a streaming service, because the old way of this cable stuff is just kind of gone, like the radio is. But the streaming, you could do whatever you want with that. Watch it whenever you want. And hey, man, it's perfect.
But you can also watch it live. This is something that you're like, I need to watch this immediately as it airs, because things are going to happen.
That's
you know
right.
what I'm saying? This is like watching a spaceship take off.
Well, this,
you don't want to watch it the next day.
No.
You want to watch it as it happens.
I want to see tonight, and I do want to see tonight live, is CM Punk going to talk? Will that be a thing?
I've never really known him to speak his mind. I think he's more of a
okay.
quiet,
I understand.
Demure type. I've always described him as demure.
Very good. Okay.
And then my question is, that, you know, after tonight, if he gets comfortable, if he's feeling good, will he sit down with me and do an episode of AEW?
Well, this is what I'm more looking forward to. Will he do AEW? Because that is worth, hey, take my money now. Just take my money now.
Well, I will tell you this. About a year ago, he gave me a verbal commitment that he would do one. Obviously, he then got injured. He was not around.
Yes.
The timing was not right.
Yes.
But if you know anything about me, is that I never forget things. I hold on to very small things for a very long time.
Yes.
So when I see him, I will absolutely say, hey, are you a man of your word?
You're supposed to do that interview with me, and I think you're the perfect guy to do the interview with. I mean, you're the one that's going to open up. You're the one that's getting get him to open up and get him to talk. You know, he, like you say, he kind of keeps himself a little bit introverted, but you're going to bring it out in full broadcast.
Yeah, they call me the Barbara Walters of the wrestling business. For
you are. You definitely are. You definitely are. Yeah. RJ City, you are absolutely the greatest, for sure. I love you and your new TV wife, Renee Paquette on TSN. That's amazing.
Don't, first of all, not the TV wife. We are known as the Wrestle Ants.
Oh, the Wrestle Ants.
Watching wrestling with us is like cracking a bottle of wine and hanging out with your fun, wacky wrestling ants.
That makes total sense to me. That makes total sense to me.
Yeah.
This is beautiful. RJ, I love you. Do you have any more? I'm not going to keep you because I know you got a huge show.
I'm going to say I love you back because you've said it three times now and I wanted to even up the score.
I want to make sure.
And I'm so excited. You know, I've wrestled in Toronto a very long time. So have you. And you know, weird things always happen in wrestling shows in Canada.
Yes.
And I guarantee that streak will continue next week.
Yes, yes. And RJ, I'm throwing it out there. I know you're a busy man. I know you may not be able to do this, but if you want to come back on next week and talk about Toronto, hey, you have a home right here at 4680Q.
Well, thank you. I might take you up in the office. Hey, you know what? Let's see how tonight goes.
Let's see how tonight goes, because if anything bad happens, I might not want it on the radio. But other than that, you're welcome back here. You know what I mean?
Sounds good to me. My radio casa, a Sioux radio casa.
And hold on. Pat Porter, stop it. RJ, you still there?
Yes.
Yes, my, you know, board operator. I'm going to play a song for you. I'm going to play a song for you.
You played the wrong song,
stop
Jay.
Stop it, Pat Porter. I'm trying to do an interview.
Well, now I'm insulted.
Yes, I was going to do Elton John's Saturday Night's All Ready for Fighting, because that's the song we're doing today. And one more time, RJ City! Hey, how's that, pal?
Okay. You know what? I'll take it. I accept
All
it.
Right.
At the beginning, I didn't like it, but you won me over.
Yes. I will see you tonight on my TSN Plus, pal.
Yes. Goodbye.
Say hi to Sean Spears. Thank you.
I guess. Bye.
All right, Jay, so are you going to play the right song this time? Or?
Don't blame me, Pal.
It's your fault. I know it's your fault.
The beginning of tonight's theme.
Yeah.
AEW Collision, Elton John.
Hey, tell me when you're ready.
I am ready.
Okay, hit it. There you go.
Oh, Pat Porter?
Yeah, Jay Moore.
Saturday night is all right for fighting a little Elton John, and that's the beginning tonight of AEW Collision. Special thanks to RJ City for calling in today.
One thing I got to mention, the fact that you are, as we always tell everybody, you're the manager of champions in
Thank
the wrestling
you.
World.
Yes.
You still are, and you've taken on a new client. Now, can we talk about that new client that you've added to your repertoire?
We're
going to
talk about we're later on in the program, and hopefully the next 10, 15 minutes, we're talking to Sarah Theroux.
Yeah.
She's from Aroma Sarah Therapy.
What does that have to do with your wrestling manager?
It has nothing to do with it. She's opening up a new store. We're going to talk about her new store. But Pat Porter, tell them what's going on at the Regency and all the other stores.
So, in other words, we're going to skip by your new client.
Well,
wrestling.
I think it's better to have her in on air and discuss it on air as opposed to me.
Does she know about this?
She's nervous.
Oh, okay.
She's nervous. She's
We'll talk about that later in the show. Then.
Yeah.
So we'll talk about the Regency Athletic Resort, Mountain Road, Niagara Falls, right at the QEW. They have great entertainment all summer long. In fact, I'm looking at June 24th, Svengali's 30th anniversary bash. That goes with the first band on stage at 5 o'clock in the afternoon.
Mm.
Yeah. Canada Day, Sons of Neil Young. And then Destroyer, a Kiss cover band, coming up the 8th of July.
Okay.
I've seen them. I think you've seen them, too.
Yeah, we saw them over at... what's
Big Texas.
Big Texas, was it? Okay, yes.
That's right. Simply Journey coming. Journey covers, doing that on the 15th of July. Foo Fighters, that band is Monkey Wrench on July 22nd.
Yeah.
Bon Jovi Forever.
Yes.
The women like Bon Jovi.
The women love Bon Jovi, yes.
Yeah, July 29th. And then, can we do, we got, five here in August. I'll mention them quickly.
Eh? Okay.
In August, the 5th, Dustin Bones, Guns N' Roses covers. The Beach Boy Experience, August 12th, Just Heart on the 19th, and Wicked Truth on the 25th, and also on the 25th, Dizzy Rex in that 70s show.
Oh, that's going to be great.
All happening at the Regency Athletic Resort in Mountain Road, Niagara Falls.
Yes, that's going to be great, Pat Porter.
You know what else is happening up there? You got to give credit to Greg Keenan, the owner, and to the manager of the Regency, Sean Duff.
Yeah.
These guys put on great shows.
They put on great shows. They don't mind to amp it up and get it out there. They're putting a lot of money into getting these shows out there and doing more than what most do. And I think I've always said it. I've said it every podcast. You're probably getting tired of me saying it, but it is the best place to see live music right now.
Indoors or outdoors?
Indoors, outdoors. They got you covered. Food, drinks, anything you want. Lots of room. You can
volleyball,
park there. You
can
even get a hotel right there.
Yeah.
On the premise.
You're kind of wobbly on the way out, they got a room for you.
They got a room for you. So it's absolutely perfect. I love it over there at the Regency Mountain Road and the QEW,
Athletic Resort, the other partner that we should mention, Canada Day Rock and Blues
the
on the battlefield. Yeah.
Yes.
Now, we emceed this last year. It was a great event, about 4,000 people outdoors on Canada Day. Now, this year it's Canada Day and the 2nd, which is Sunday. So, Saturday and Sunday at the Battle of Beaver Dams Park. Bob Lidicote puts this together every year with his team at the city of Thorold.
Yeah.
Mayor Terry Ugolini is going to be there this year for sure. I'm sure he'll get on stage and he'll have something to
but
say.
But does he play a ukulele?
Terry Ugolini with his ukulele.
I mean, ukulele. That should be his gimmick. He can make money doing that.
We just lost that sponsorship. Anyway, that's happening at the Bandshell, 64 Front Street, right near downtown. Not hard to find. You can walk from downtown.
Yeah.
Corner of Sullivan Avenue in Thorold. Dave Rave is going to open up on Saturday at 4 o'clock.
Yes. Now, in a couple weeks, I'm looking at getting Dave Rave on this show. I don't want you to steal my guest. Okay, like you did with Roddy Michaels.
You just told me that.
Yeah, I know. I want you to know, and I want that.
My first phone call is going to be to Dave Rave.
I want the audience to know that you heard it here first. He's supposed to be on this show, not the Pat Porter show.
All right, I'll let you do Dave Rave on your show then.
Thank you.
Marty Allen Band at 6 o'clock on the 1st.
Excellent.
Vinyl Flux.
Yes, we all know Vinyl Flux.
These guys are the best there is.
They just did a big show last night in Grimsby where they closed the entire street down.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
And they were at the Mudcat Festival before
just
that.
Just a week before that, they did Shirkston. And, of course, they're going to close out that battlefield on, the Saturday?
Yeah. No, on the Saturday, July 1st.
That's right. Just
fireworks
right after. And Vinyl Flux, you can't go wrong.
These guys, they're working all the time. Everybody wants to hire them and put them on stage because their music is, as we've talked
before.
Cut for cut. Exactly.
That's right.
You can't tell that it isn't Fleetwood Mac or ZZ Top or whomever it is that they're tributing.
That's right. And that's then, right, Pat Porter.
I'm glad you say something I said is right to Infamous Jay Moore. Thank you. Mark that down. Well, Let me mark that down.
It's only because you're reading it. It's okay. not from your own thoughts.
It's all from my memory.
Right.
Here. July 2nd, the Sunday, again at the Battle of Beaver Dams Park, Riley Michaels. We talked to Riley yesterday.
Yeah.
I did. You didn't.
Yeah, of course you did.
Yeah, you were doing something else. I don't know what
interview.
You were doing.
It was a good interview.
Sunning yourself on the sidewalk.
Yeah, well, you should have been here.
Riley, 2 o'clock on Sunday. The Red Dirt Revelators at 4 o'clock.
Okay.
And then the Weber brothers. And yesterday I talked to both of the brothers.
How many guests are you going to have on that show?
I don't know. All kinds.
I'm just going to keep on going. No, the Weber brothers are great. Yeah. I heard some of their music on your show yesterday.
Yeah.
And I was rocking out in my own vehicle.
No kidding. Yeah. They were great.
Yeah.
They were great. Hailing from Baltimore, Maryland. And they spent a lot of time in Canada.
Yeah.
They came to Canada to hook up with Ronnie Hawkins. And
Ronnie
put him through a 90-day boot camp.
Yeah, he taught them.
Yeah.
Mm.
He taught them showmanship, primarily, because they were already musicians.
Yeah.
But he taught them showmanship.
This is how you
stage.
Do shows here in around the Toronto area. And
all over Canada.
All over Canada, and nobody knows how to do it better than Ronnie Hawkins.
That's right,
sure.
Yeah. And then closing out the show on Sunday the 2nd is Monkey Junk at 8 o'clock.
Monkey Junk? Are you allowed to say that?
I said it.
Yeah.
I said it. Monkey Junk.
Yeah, yeah. You would have been fired at
Let's look that up.
Radio.
Let's look that up and see what that really means.
No, don't do that, Pat.
Okay.
You'll get in trouble.
So thanks to Bob Letticoat and the team for rocking blues on the Battlefield Canada Day and Sunday the 2nd as well.
Excellent.
Free. No charge. Free.
No charge for this.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Bring your lawn chair.
Perfect.
All right.
Pat Porter, I say we play a little Aerosmith while we're waiting for our guest and take the rest of the show from there.
All right. Hit it. Anytime.
Walk this way, baby.
Oh, this way.
4-6-8.
Funny way. Ooh.
She was doing what she told me how to walk this way. She told me to.
All right, there you go. Walk This Way, Aerosmith here. 4680Q or 4680Q, as Jay likes to say.
.com.ca, we don't know.
Jay, can I promote what's coming up on my show?
You got more promotions. You're going to use my show to promote all your stuff and your show to interview my guests.
Yeah.
All right.
Why not? Yeah, okay. I'm going to be talking to Australian Pink Floyd. They're coming to Lewiston Art Park on the 28th of June.
Oh, that would be a good one.
Yeah. That's a great one.
Yeah.
We have Pink Floyd Niagara right here in Niagara. Of course, these guys are fantastic.
Yes, the best in the area.
Yeah. Probably in the world. But I would say maybe second best would be Australian Pink Floyd.
Well, so. Ashley would like that because she's never left Australia in her head.
Okay. Ashley's your lady. Mm-hmm. Can we tell people that? All right.
You can. She doesn't like to tell people
she's
that.
She's so much better looking than you are. How'd you ever land a woman like that?
I don't know. I don't know.
She's smart, too.
Okay. Enough of that. Okay. I'm with your plugs.
Right. And then also, I'm going to be talking to Savoy Brown. Now, they're a big band that have a new album. They've got all kinds of albums out. I'm going to be talking to the drummer, Garnet Grimm.
Yeah.
So we'll tell you more about that when we get a little bit closer to the date that we're going to have them on. But it looks pretty good. We're going to have some big stars on here.
Yeah, Pat Porter.
Yeah, so, okay, that and Savoy Brown. I'll tell you a little bit about Savoy Brown.
Oh, okay.
English blues rock band formed in Battersea, southwest London, back in 65. So these are back in the days of the Beatles, the Stones, and the Who, and all those great bands. Part of the 60s blues rock movement, Savoy Brown primarily achieved success in the U.S., where they promoted their albums with nonstop touring. So they're from London, England, but we're going to put them on the air. We're going to talk to them about what's happening in Niagara and what they're doing in Toronto.
Oh, excellent.
Well.
So that's all on your show, Friday.
Yeah, that's my show. Yeah. What do you got on your show? Nothing?
Well, my guest has not shown up here yet, so she's running late. Give me 5 minutes late. Do you want to throw to another song, Pat Porter?
Yeah, what do you got there?
Well,
you got something
this is
good?
Something that has never been played. I'm sure you've never played on your show before. How about a little Godsmack?
Okay.
Don't laugh. This is a good
I'm not
one.
Laughing.
You're gonna like this.
Yeah.
Jay Moore, Rocky Mountain Way, Joe Walsh's big song.
It's not Joe Walsh, it's Godsmack.
Well, yeah, I know. It was them, but I mean, Joe Walsh wrote the song.
Yes, I should have let you finish, but you know what? I'm trying to talk about Godsmack, that you would never play that on your
show. How do you know? How do you know?
I know you. I
yeah,
know
you.
I
don't know what
it's,
I'm going to play.
It's all about the oldies. It's all about
yeah,
the
I'm
going to
play Tiptoe Through the Tulips by Tiny Tim on your show.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Your turn.
Can you at least shut the studio door, Pat Porter? We got people talking everywhere. You're laughing. You know what?
Yeah,
this is the
what?
Thing you want to sabotage this show is each and every week.
No, I know. I love your show.
Great about yours.
I love your show. You know why I love it?
Why?
Because I'm on it. Yeah, makes sense.
Why the ratings are down.
Oh, come on. Come on.
The great Sarah Theroux is here.
Yeah.
Yes,
all
my
right.
dear friend for many, many years.
Okay, can I? You want me to shut up for a bit then?
No, you don't have to shut up.
Okay, I won't.
Yeah, of course. Let's say something then.
Introduce Sarah here. Tell us about her.
Yes, the great Sarah Theroux from Aromatherapy. Am
Hi.
I right?
Yes. Yes, that is correct.
Yes.
Hello,
yes.
Hello.
And this is how I wanted to introduce you, because I love this. Introverted, inked, and slightly inappropriate.
A lot inappropriate.
That sums you up. A lot inappropriate. Look at you, Pat Porter.
What? What am I doing?
You just can't believe it.
What? Believe what? How you always bring these great-looking women in here? You had Joni Jane in the other day.
Yes. Yeah. Now you're sounding very creepish.
No,
you're an old man doing creepy
things. I can mention if somebody looks good. I just don't mention if they don't look good. That's all.
Oh, I see.
See, I'm fair.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, you don't do that to me.
Well, you don't look good.
No, I know.
You put a hat on and pulled your scarf up over your nose, maybe you'd be fine.
Aromatherapy. Tell us about that. You got a new store opening up?
I do. It is...
Well, first of all, before we even get there, how did this whole thing come about? Because everybody knows you from the real estate world a few years ago.
Yep.
Yes, and you've gotten out of that pretty much.
Well,
I mean,
no,
you still
no,
do some...
still doing it, still doing it.
Yes.
Yeah.
But your passion, I think... I don't know. Am I trying to throw too much shade on you? Because
No.
I know
no.
you love real estate, but this is a passion project as far as I'm concerned.
Okay, well, it's funny that you say that, because this was my therapy to real estate.
Oh.
Is how this started.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Please elaborate.
So, well, now, 5 years later, here we are, and I now have a store.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
In July.
Yes.
On the 9th.
But the whole thing is, going into the store are these handmade items that you make, specifically the mugs, and specifically potty mouth mugs. They don't say your traditional Hallmark kind of things.
They do not.
I guess they got to have Jay Moore's picture on every potty mouth mug, eh?
Some of them do.
Some of them do. Yes.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm a big customer, and I'm a proud customer, Pat Porter.
Yep.
All right.
So this was your therapy coming out of real estate. You're kind of doing your own thing. You found yourself making these mugs. That kind of exploded everywhere across, you know, the neighborhoods that you were living in. You were selling these mugs. The potty mouth mugs, which is kind of a niche, kind of your thing. And now it's gotten to the point where 4 years later, you're in Fawn Hill opening a store, 1433 to be exact, Pelham Street, Pat Porter. See, you say I don't do show prep. There you go.
Yeah, you got it all scribbled down there. How can you make that stuff out?
I got it down.
You know what I do? Look at this. Look at my show prep. All typed up.
Yeah, that's a waste of time.
Typed up. Yeah, I mean, you got it highlighted. Yeah, and you got scribbles there that nobody, not even a monkey could read that.
I can read it. 1433. And nobody has to read it because I'm saying it on the air anyway.
All right,
so they just have to listen.
I guess if a monkey can read it, you can read it.
You're ruining the whole interview.
Go ahead. Carry on.
So you must be proud.
I'm very proud.
You ever think you were going to do this? Did you ever think it was going to get to the level of it's going to be in a store now?
No.
No.
No. I am very proud. And there is going to be a lot of potty mouth humor.
Now what, give me some examples of some potty mouth humor.
Okay, so we have, do you want to know what
I'm
selling?
What would be on the mugs?
Am I allowed to swear?
Yes. Not
okay.
too harsh though.
For example... We have a lot of the C word.
Oh.
There's a lot. You have to come and check it out.
Okay.
There's too many. There's too much.
Yes, yes, yes. So everything is potty mouth?
Not everything.
Okay.
I am having maybe 90%.
90%. So you're specializing in this. Is it all mugs?
No. So there is going to be a ton of shit. I have a ton of amazing vendors. It's not all potty mouth. You can find macrame there. There's plants there. It's just a lot of swearing and sarcastic humor.
Yes, yes, yes. So there's
great gifts.
There's other vendors in there as well.
Yes.
So, and are you, is there other vendors that have available spots?
Yes.
Still.
Yes, I am still accepting.
So you can be a part of the store.
Absolutely.
But it has to be a handmade item.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And kind of unique. We like unique.
Yeah, of course.
Swearing is encouraged.
Yeah. So this is where you can get your gift pack, Porter.
Yeah.
Because there's lots of people in the family that would enjoy it.
My family would love potty mouth. Yeah, sure.
Potty mouth. My family would love it too, you know.
I'll give something to my grandmother like that with a picture of you on it. You know.
Oh, that would be great.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Do that. Can they make orders?
Absolutely.
Yeah, so you could put whatever you want on there. Like a customer can submit something and you will put an order together.
Absolutely. And I do that with my custom candles as well.
Yes. Well, there you go. Custom candles as well. So you have that going on. You know what I was thinking would be great for the store? Because I know you like to smoke so much.
Obviously.
Yes. I think you should have a smoke hole at the store for the customers can smoke and then buy stuff as well.
All right. You're going to have to calm down right now.
Okay. All right. I thought it'd be a great idea. You can listen to murder podcasts.
Yes.
Smoke. You're heavily into murder. Yeah, don't look at me like that, Pat Boy.
I can look at you any way I want, Jay Moore. I got one eyebrow permanently raised when I look at you.
Into the murder podcast.
Yep, she is.
Yes, she is. Look at it.
This could be a murder podcast.
It is a murder.
If you screw up the show.
The whole thing. You murdered the whole thing. You brought the whole show down.
Come on.
Level.
Carry on with your interview. This sounds good, all this potty stuff. Yeah.
Yeah.
You're going to have to go to the potty soon.
No, Pat Porter.
You're just going to have to come and say hi.
Yes.
And check it all out.
Yes. So we have no opening date on this, but we're going to be talking about this further. About when you're going to open.
I'm anticipating July 9th.
Yeah.
Soft opening.
And what is going to happen July 9th? Do we have anything going on? Do we have a band? Do we have cakes, cookies? Do we have a party?
Well, now I feel like we have to.
Yeah. I don't mean to put you on the spot.
I have an idea.
Yeah.
Have a big cake and have you jump out of it.
Oh, my God, please.
Yeah, Jay Moore.
It's happening.
Jump out of it. Yeah.
1430.
Wouldn't that be great? People love that, eh?
Bon Hill.
Oh.
No, I will be there, though, Pat Porter.
I know.
I'm supporting.
I'll bring the cake. You can jump out of it.
I'm supporting. I'm buying mugs. You should be there as well. Everybody should be there.
We'll all be there.
I agree.
Yes. Yeah. The banner's out front. I've seen a picture of it. Coming soon. Aroma Serotherapy.
I'll get another mug with your picture on it. I've got a few already with your picture on it.
Yes, yes. Hey, those mugs are hot sellers. And
I'm wearing a shirt with your picture on it. What's wrong with me, eh?
I don't know.
I don't have one of those.
No.
You don't? They're rare.
No. And I'm out of mugs, to be honest.
Okay.
I just gave my last mug to my aunt for her birthday.
Okay. I know someone that can hook you up.
My only personal mug. Yes. Yes.
Now he cups his hand and drinks. Yeah.
Pat Porter, the jokes are just real.
No, not a joke. It's a true story.
Yes. Yes. Are you nervous, Sarah? Are you wanting out of here?
She's ready to run away from the studio as fast as she can.
All right, I'll wrap it up. Do you have any more, Sarah, or no?
I don't. No. No, thank you.
We're just happy to be here. You're happy that the store is going to open. Pelham Street in Fawn Hill, 1433. Potty Mouth, Pat Porter. Candles. Get your candles, get your mugs, get your merchandise. There's other vendors there. And soft opening July the 9th. How's that?
Yes.
Yes, and what about your website? What about your Facebook?
You can find me www.aromatherapy.ca.
Aromatherapy. I told you had it wrong.
With the S, yeah. Aromatherapy.
Yes.
Yeah.
But I like aromatherapy.
Okay.
Now you're confusing everybody.
Aromatherapy. Say it again, Sarah.
Aromatherapy.
No, the website.
www.aromatherapy.ca.
There you go, Pat Porter.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Go buy something.
Yeah, I'm going to buy something.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah.
I like potty stuff.
Do you like potty stuff?
Yeah, why not?
I like potty stuff.
I know you do.
Down there.
Yeah. I'm aware.
Yeah. Pat Porter, we will play a song. And we're
going to
come back with Chris if he's available from Port Dalhousie Supply Market.
Okay.
Yeah.
I want to please take me home.
Guns N' Roses in Paradise City on the infamous Jay Moore Show with Pat Porter. Jay, what do you got to tell me?
I don't think we're getting to our last guest. I was going to call Chris from Port Toulouse Supply Company, but he's unavailable.
All right. We'll save him. We'll get him on another show.
We'll save him. Why don't you tell me about the
oh, this is exciting.
That's all you've done all day is promote your stuff.
No, this is our thing. Oh, okay. This is going to, both of us are going to be there. Thunder River Bike Fest 2023.
Yes.
Now, last year, I was sick. I couldn't make it, so you didn't take part either. But this year, this is the second time.
Yeah.
August 12th and 13th at the Welland Fairgrounds. There goes a bike right now.
Yeah.
Two of them.
See what happens when you open up the window?
Yeah.
It's all coming together. It's magic. We're talking about bikes and the bikes rolled by.
That's right.
Yeah.
So this is going to be a big event. And now this is with all the bikers that are going to be there. It's going to be a lot of fun. Lynn and Dave are putting this together. Mm-hmm. They're hosting it.
Yeah.
Chico Sanchez is going to be
there. He's always at these.
Chico is everywhere.
Yeah.
For one good reason.
Yeah.
He does a great job.
He does do a good job, but Chico is everywhere.
Yeah. So also it's going to be hosted by Bro Niagara, and they're one of the charities that are going to benefit.
Yeah.
Riders Protecting Children Canada, UN NATO veterans are also going to benefit. Birchway Women's Shelter, Pathstones Mental Health for Children, and UN NATO Veterans Community Outreach Program. August 12th and 13th at the Welland Fairgrounds, Thunder River Bike Fest 23. Cost you $5 to get in.
That's nothing.
That's it. $5.
Yeah, that's nothing.
Yeah.
I mean, if you would pay me, I could do it, but you don't pay me.
I'll tell you what, I'll pay for half of your ticket. How's that?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Do you have $250?
I'll try and rummage around somewhere in my piggy bank and see if I can find it.
Hey, listen, I couldn't get to our last guest because obviously he's busy, but I just want to make quick note. It's about the Port Toulouse Supply Company in Port Toulouse.
Yeah.
Can you figure that out, Pat Porter? Yes.
That makes sense.
Port Toulouse Supply Company in Port Toulouse.
You got it.
They're having their supper market at Lakeside Park June 20th. And this is going to be huge, Pat Porter. Beer, wine, cocktails, food trucks, the whole thing. This is going to be happening every Tuesday from the 20th to August 29th, and we're opening it up huge on the 20th.
We're going to get down there, are we?
We're not going to get down there. I'm not going anywhere with you, but I am going to be going.
Thanks a lot. Yeah.
Because on stage is the Great Figure Four.
Yeah, so I don't get to go on stage with them?
You can go on stage, Pat Porter, but I don't want to be seen anywhere with you.
No, thanks a lot. Thanks. You're banned from all my my shows. Any of the shows that are coming up, you're banned. It's just going to be me.
Listen, you just sound whiny. You just sound whiny. No. I'm trying to say something great about the
You didn't invite me.
Chris at the Port Toulouse Supply Company at Lakeside Park.
Hey, I did a show with Figure Four on St. Patrick's Day.
Yeah?
We blew the roof off of the Meriton Community Center.
And St. Patrick's Day doesn't mean it's your day, by the way. You think because it's got your name in it that it's your day.
Yeah, it's about, is there anything that has to do with Jay? Any special day?
Yes, this show does, Pat Porter, and you ruined the whole show today. And it's been quite uncomfortable to sit here with you.
Yeah, I'm glad you opened the window. It was getting uncomfortable for me, the way it was stinking up the room here.
Pat Porter, I'm ending the show early because I can't take it anymore. Special thanks to Chris, who didn't make it today. Special thanks to RJ City.
It's going to be a podcast at 4680Q.com soon.
They're starting AEW Collision tonight. You can get that on TSN Plus. And special thanks to Sarah Theroux with Aroma Therapy.
Say that again.
Aromatherapy. Am I right?
Therapy.
Yes. Yeah. Aromatherapy, her new store.
Yeah.
1433 Pelham Street. Soft opening on the 9th of July.
All kinds of potty stuff.
Yeah, all kinds of potty stuff.
Potty mouth, I guess. Wait, what are you?
Yes.
Potties.
Look up Aromatherapy and you can get all your items there. All the information's there.
I'm going to shop there.
Yes, yes, yes. And Figure Four. Oh, do you want to do your stupid plugs?
For what?
Next week, Friday at 3, your Pat Porter show.
I'm not telling anybody yet what I've got.
Friday at 3, Pat Porter show. He's not going to tell anybody what's going on.
No, I do have Savoy Brown next week.
Okay, Friday. So you just told us. Next Saturday, we're back here at 3 o'clock. And I'm going to end the show early because I can't take it in here anymore. But I'm going to end the song from, Figure Four knows how to play this. Yeah. They're going to play it on Tuesday when we see them down in Port Toulouse. Not a huge Rush fan, but I am a Rush fan when this comes on.
Neil Peart.
Lakeside Park, baby. That's how we're ending it. We'll see you in Port Toulouse Tuesday night.
See you Friday. See you Saturday. Next weekend.
Yes, 4680Q.